everybody, it's Carlene the Pink Scrapper, and I wanted to show you this new technique that I learned at a scrapbook store. I took a class there, and I was looking at these cards that they made, and I couldn't figure out the technique that they used. So, of course, I had to take the class and figure out what they did. And they actually used the Tim Holtz daubbers, and I will do another video on the technique that I learned, but this is something else that they showed me, is if you want to cover some brads, this is just plain gold from the office supply store, you can put them in a styrofoam piece, and I didn't have any things styrofoam in my house except for this, and I'm going to actually make something out of this. So anyways, it's going to be dual purpose. So, and then I wanted to show you this cool tin that I got from my local craft store, and I haven't painted it yet, but I will. But the daubbers fit in here perfectly, so I've got a couple of these, and so that's where how I'm going to store things. So on the new daubbers, there's a valve that's in there that you have to depress, and see, it got on my finger. So what you need to do is you need to press down on that valve, and so there you go. It's really easy to do. I just gave it a little squeeze when I was starting it, and actually this one I think is a little bit thin. You can see on there, let's see if I can shake. I tried to shake it up really good, but it didn't seem to work. Well, it looks a little bit better. Let's see if it works. Okay, so you just put your brads into a styrofoam piece. I'm going to start this one up. This one's a very cool color. It is called Espresso. And instead of using that one's called Pool, and I need to mix that one a little better. I'm going to use my Espresso and just cover up the top heads. And when I was in that class, I noticed I wasn't able to get the sides of it, so I actually picked mine up to do it because I was too anal to not do the sides. So I picked mine up, and then we just let it dry like this in our styrofoam, and after that we put stickles on it, and we used the distress stickles. And right now the only one I have is the ice stickles, so I'm not going to do that. But that's how you can also, another way to color your brads a different color. You can also use your Copic markers, I've done that too, or the alcohol inks from Ranger are good too. So anyways, I'm gonna let that dry, and let's push this off to the side. The other thing that I wanted to do was try and antique this foot plate a little bit. I seen something in Tim Holtz's new book that showed him distressing that a little bit. So I'm going to try that. This isn't the same exact color, but it's going to match with my garden book. So this is just another way to use your ink daubbers. Okay, so he just went ahead and covered it like so, and I'm actually going to stir this so it doesn't seem to be thick enough for me. Just going to use my skewer that I use for my melting pot, and I'll mix that up, because when I'm pouncing it on this book plate, I can tell that it looks really watery. It's not sticking like it should. So anyways, there's my first blooper. Actually, not my first blooper, but just something that kind of went wrong while I was taping. But it's good because you guys can see how I try to fix it. Okay, so I'm going to see if this is sticky enough. Yeah, that's a lot better. Okay, so here we go. Coating it on. And in the video, or actually in the book, he just used a paper towel and kind of wiped that off to give it an antique-y look. So that's what I'm doing. And this is going to match with my garden book. Hopefully. Okay. So I'm just going to let that dry. And you'll see it in my garden book when I do my next video. So, anyways, hope you enjoyed that. Thanks for watching.